Hi everyone, and welcome to today's Chinese Pod lesson. My name is Joe.
大家好，欢迎来到中文播客，我是庆林。
In today's class, we are going to talk about things that go missing or that are not there anymore, especially about things that are not there anymore in offices. So what are some things that we generally can find in offices?
打印机
A printer
柜子
A shelf or a cabinet and a pen. So let's check out the dialogue and see what's gone missing here.
打印机没纸了。
柜子里有。
笔没水了。
抽屉里有新的。
我找找。打印机没纸了。
柜子里有。
笔没水了。
抽屉里有新的，
我找找。打印机没纸了，
柜子里有。
笔没水了，
抽屉里有新的，
我找找。
After listening to this dialogue, let's check it out line by line.
打印机没纸了。
The printer ran out of paper.
打印机没纸了。
The printer ran out of paper.
打印机没纸了。柜子里有。
There's paper in the cabinet.
柜子里有。
There's paper in the cabinet.
柜子里有。笔没水了。
The pen ran out of ink.
笔没水了。
The pen ran out of ink.
笔没水了。抽屉里有新的。
There's a new one in the drawer.
抽屉里有新的。
There's a new one in the drawer.
抽屉里有新的。我找找。
Let me check.
我找找。
Let me check.
我找找。
In this dialogue, we have two colleagues speaking about things that are not or are in the office. Before we talk about all those things in detail and analyze them line by line, let's shortly talk about the structures that we have here in the dialogue. So, in Chinese, we have a verb that means to have.
有。
If you wanted to negate this verb and say, I don't have, what would you say?
没有。
Okay, and this is similar used in Chinese as it is used in English. So you can say, I have something and I don't have something, just with those verbs and this negation form. So what do you have that I don't have?
我有长发。
Oh, you have long hair. Yeah, I don't. So 我没有。
你没有。我有。耳环。
You have an earring. I don't have that either, so 我没有。
你没有。
Mm-hmm. In Chinese, however, you can use this verb 有 in another sense, because if you pair this up with a place and then add it to the place, it becomes something like a there is.
中国有长城。
Ah, so that's a good example here. So,we have here China, then the verb 有, and then the word for Great Wall. So it's actually China has the Great Wall, which is more or less a there is a Great Wall or the Great Wall in China. So this 有 is more of a there is something. Do we have another example?
桌上有充电器.
Oh, okay, so the first one was on the table, then again have or has, and a charger.So this together becomes, there is a charger on the table. And this is actually why many Chinese native speakers have that common mistake in English that they say, for example, on the table has a charger. You will hear this probably from native Chinese speakers a lot because of this verb, 有, which means to have and there is. So let's check how this 有 and 没有 is used in our dialogue.
打印机没纸了。
So this is the first line of the dialogue, and here you'll find the words for printer.
打印机。打 印机。
And then the word for paper.
纸纸
Okay, and then we have two other small words here. Let's not care about the last word first, but about the word that is in the middle of paper and printer.
没
So this is actually a short version of the thing we just told you, which is don't have.
没有
So what often happens in Chinese is that you leave out this 有 and you just take the 没 especially when it's paired with the one we just left out, with the last word in this line. The last word here is a so-called particle, and this particle is...
了
This particle means that something just changed, something has changed. So this is why this together with 没 or 没有would be like something is not there anymore. So it's like I have just noticed that it's not there anymore. Maybe we can practice this structure in some other examples.
好手机没电了
Oh, like, oops, myself.
Hello, we are so glad that you're enjoying this video so far, but you're not getting the full lesson here. The full lesson and the rest of this video are available on our site, ChinesePod.com. Give it a try and see how much more we have to offer. We have exercises, expanded examples, vocabulary, and downloadable material.You cannot get that here on YouTube. So, visit our website today, enter GRACE as the promo code, and get 20% off our premium subscriptions. I'll see you at ChinesePod.com.
But hurry, only the first 300 subscribers are allowed to redeem this deal. Use promo code GRACE for 20% off your entire premium subscription and launch your real learning experience. ChinesePod, ChinesePod.